fourth ventricle, which includes two velum. Velum medullaris superior, this one, is thin layer of white matter which connects peduncle cerebellaris superioris. And velum medullaris inferior, no, this velum is absent here, only this small part of this velum you can show and I can show. And this velum locates between pedunculi flocculi. Flocculus is the smallest portion of the cerebellum, which has peduncle which connects nodus, portion of vermis cerebellus, flocculus. And between these peduncles present velum medullaris inferior. Main peculiarity of this velum that is only fibrous tissue and vessels includes in this velum, not nerve tissue, such as in superior velum, only telecharaida and flexus charaida. And in velum medullaris inferior, there are three aperture is located, paired lateral aperture or apertura lushka, and unpaired medial aperture or apertura majanti. You have to describe next time all aperture in velum medullaris inferior, plus two openings which communicate cavity of fourth ventricle with aqueduct of midbrain, apertura aqueductus cerebri, and with spinal cord canal, canalis spinalis, below from the rhomboid fossa and from the fourth ventricle. Then bottom of fourth ventricle is formed by rhomboid fossa. But topography of rhomboid fossa or relief, I will show on the picture only. Here you can see aqueduct. It's cavity of midbrain which communicate with fourth ventricle. Which fourth ventricle is located here between medulla oblongata pons ventrally and cerebellum dorsally. Well, follow me.
Follow what I remember.
Now, relief of rhomboid fossa includes sulcus medianus, stria medullaris, there are fibers of white matter which has horizontal direction and separate rhomboid fossa on two triangles. Upper triangle is dorsal surface of pons. Lower triangle is dorsal surface of myelencephalon or medulla oblongata. Laterally from the median groove, eminencia medialis is located, which is bounded by sulcus limitans laterally. In lower portion of eminencia medialis, there are two paired triangles, trigonum nervi hypoglossi and trigonum nervi vagi are located. Upwardly from stria medullaris on eminencia medialis, there are two tubercles, one tubercle, but paired, which is called colliculus facialis. In these collicles, nuclei of nervus facialis and nervus abducens are located in the deep portion of substance of metal of the pons. Lateral part is called lateral angle or area vestibularis. There are vestibular nuclei of 8 pair of vestibular cochlear nerve allocated. And this small blue area is called locus ceruleus. It's a blue point of the rhomboid fossa. Then, inside, in matter of the pons and myelencephalon, there are nuclei of cranial nerves located. You have to draw in your copy books this nuclei on rhomboid fossa and have to study this nuclei very well. You may show rhomboid fossa, main elements of relief of rhomboid fossa, collicles, triangles, and then all motor nuclei of rhomboid fossa, there are nuclei of cranial nerve from 5th up to 12th pair, locates medially the lower eminenza medialis. All these nuclei locate here. More upwardly, nucleus motorius of nervus trigeminus is present near all the blue point of rhomboid fossa. Then below, stop talking! Shut up! Below collicles, nucleus nervi abducentis, motor nuclei, and nucleus facialis are located together, one deeper than another nuclei. Nucleus nervi abducentis is 6 pair, nucleus nervi facialis 7 pair. Then on the level of trigonum nervi hypoglossi, down below, big nuclei, which is called nucleus ambiguus, is present. This motor nuclei is common for 9, 10, and 11 pair. Then 11 pair, which is called nervus accessorius, has another motor nuclei, which has very long structure and locates up to the upper segments of spinal cord. That's why this nuclei is called nucleus spinalis nervi accessori. And at last, in trigonum of hypoglossal nerve, nucleus nervi hypoglossi is present. Nucleus nervi hypoglossi, or 12 pair. There are all motor nuclei. Then, laterally in rhomboid fossa, some sensitive nuclei are present. First of all, nervus trigeminus has 3 sensitive nuclei, which is named according to its relief, to its topography. Upper nuclei is located in the midbrain up to the upper portion of pons. And this nuclei is called nucleus mesencephalicus of nervus trigeminus. The biggest nuclei, which locates in pons, is called nucleus principalis or nucleus pontinus, according to topography, of trigeminal nerve. And at last, the longest nuclei and lowest, present in spinal cord and lower part of medulla oblongata. That's why this nuclei is called nucleus spinalis of trigeminal nerve. Then one common nuclei locates in myelencephalon, and this common nuclei is called nucleus tractus solitarii. It's common for 7 fascial, 9 glossopharyngeal, and 10 vagus nerves. This nuclei of taste sensitivity, and in lateral portion of rhomboid fossa, on both sides, of course, there are nucleo-vestibulo-cochlear nerves are present. Cochlear nuclei, dorsal and ventral, and 4 vestibular nuclei. All these nuclei are nuclei of nervus vestibulo-cochlearis, nucleus cochlearis dorsalis, nucleus cochlearis ventralis. You have to name all of it. Nucleus vestibularis dorsalis, nucleus vestibularis ventralis, nucleus vestibularis medialis and lateralis. And at last, third group of nuclei, there are autonomic or parasympathetic nuclei. These nuclei present on both sides between motor and sensitive nuclei. There are only 3 nuclei here. You have to show this nuclei by green or violet color. And this nuclei locates above and below from stria medullaris, and last nuclei locates in trigonum nervi vagi. Upper nuclei is called nucleus salivatorius. This nucleus controls process of salivation of the salivary gland of the head. Salivatorius superior, its nuclei of fascial nerve. Salivatorius inferior, its nuclei of glossopharyngeal nerve, and the lowest nuclei, which locates in trigonum nervi vagi, its nucleus dorsalis, nervi vagi, or ten pair. There are all nuclei of rhomboid fossa. You have to draw the same picture in your copy books for next time. Have to study very well this nuclei. And you have to know name of each pair of cranial nerve from 5th up to 12th. All nuclei of each pair and all motor sensitive and autonomic nuclei here. This nuclei present on both sides, but I draw for you only on one side, motor and autonomic on another side. But really this nuclei present both, there are pairs. And plus you will study fourth ventricle. What does it mean, velum medullaris superius, inferius, and what communication of fourth ventricle, what openings and what places you can use. Then you take it, you may be free now.